Candidate key versus primary key. In this video, we'll look at what a candidate key is and how it's different from a primary key. There are a bunch of different key-like terms when working with databases. A candidate key is one of them, and it's often compared to a primary key. Let's get into the video. So what is a candidate key? A candidate key is any attribute that could be the primary key. When you're designing a table in the database, you look at the attributes or pieces of information you want to store about a particular object or area. One or more of these attributes could be a candidate key. Let's see an example. Let's say that you're storing information about people in a database. This could be a bank system or insurance or for the government or something like that where you need to capture and store quite a bit of information about someone. You've identified the information you want to store. First and last name, date of birth, mobile phone number, email address, and a tax ID such as a social security number, and so on. How does this relate to a candidate key? A candidate key is any of those fields that could be the primary key. Or, to put it another way, any field that can be used to uniquely identify the record. There is usually one of these in a table, and often more than one. Looking at these fields, which ones could be a candidate key? The tax ID could be a candidate key. It's most likely unique to a person, but it depends on how the country generates and uses them. So for now, it's a candidate key. Email addresses could be a candidate key. It's often used as a login to systems and usually relates to a single person. Mobile phone number may also be a candidate key as it uniquely identifies the record. There are exceptions to these, however, so they may not be a good choice for your primary key. But they could be considered candidate keys. You would usually choose your primary key from the candidate keys. So which of these is your primary key? It could be any of them, depending on the system you're designing. However, my personal preference is to avoid using attributes that have meaning in the domain you're working on, or the business, or the subject area, or the real world. This is because they can change, which can mess up your table design. So I would create a new ID field whose primary purpose is to be the primary key of the record. It would be either an auto-incrementing number or a unique alphanumeric string. This way, I can define whatever rules I need for other fields. If we want to make the tax ID unique, we can, or we can make it not unique in case it's ever reused. The same applies for other fields. So I hope that explains the difference between a candidate key and a primary key. A candidate key is an attribute that could be chosen as the primary key, and the primary key is a field that uniquely identifies the row. If you learned something new from this video, make sure to subscribe to my channel. If you want to learn more about database design and development, visit databasestar.com. That's where I share my best database-related content. Which part of this video was the most helpful for you? Was it the clarification of a candidate key? Or the example of different candidate keys for a person, or something else. Thanks for watching.